over the next couple of days. This is just a general energy update, and I hope all of you are fantastic. Thank you, Ari, for tuning in. So let's see. First, I just want to share with you, number one, still using Monate, and it's really good. So I'm at like the third week, and I have all this hairline growing back in. So I am going to get that started as soon as I can. It takes like my attention. I'll have to like focus on what I'm doing, and I haven't really had the time to get that started, because when I get it started, I want to do it right. So I don't want to half do it. Next up on my agenda is I have this cologne from the company called Dossier.co. Dossier.co. Now, I don't know if that's like .Columbia or what. I don't know, but I know it's not .com, so you might be confused, but wonderful bottle. Now, this one I love because it's from their collection called the Speakeasy Collection, which is like the boozy sort of scents. And this one is golden rum and amber. And I just really love this one so much. It is bitter almond, plum. Let's see here. Rum, clove, cedarwood, vanilla. And candied fruits. So I have no cologne on right now. And this is not like I want you to smell like me. I want you to pick the one that you love, because they have so many different scents. They have a wellness collection, which is like more spa sort of related, a eucalyptus. They have the Speakeasy collection, which is more of a nighttime sort of, you know, sort of a prohibition sort of speakeasy, boozy smells. But I love this one, golden rum and amber. It smells really, really nice. It has such a nice smell. Now, this could actually be unisex. Like, anybody could wear this one. Yeah, for sure. This could be for anybody. This could be a present for your man. But it is feminine. I mean, it's not super feminine. It's more leaning towards, like, a masculine smell, if there is such a thing as, like, a masculine smell. This is kind of like something you could get your husband or your boyfriend. So that's what we have for that. They are on dossier.com, and it's Dossier. These are fantastic. They're sourced in France, made in France, distributed here, and you can get them also, well, their website is the best place, dossier.co. Okay, so let's see what's coming up in the cards here for you, Aries. I'm trying to decide which deck to use for you. And I wish you all the very best. I hope you're doing well. Okay, Aries. Spirit and angels, please show us Aries. I hope you are fantastic. Oh, and it's hard to find a tarot deck that like speaks to your soul. And I have a tarot deck that I created, and it's on my website, and it speaks to my soul. So I put it up to sell to other individuals who may enjoy the imagery. And, you know, I used elements instead of swords and coins. I used earth and air. So you may resonate with that. All right, and I do have an oracle deck coming, which I'm pretty excited about. It's just, again, I have to spend time doing it and putting it up, and I will. Maybe I'll do it today. So let's see what we have here for Aries today. Spirit and angels, the star card, hope for the future, hope and healing, hope for the future. The star represents a recovery after something happened to you. after you went through something difficult, usually not something easy. The star represents like it's behind you now. You can look forward to the future. It is this Aquarius card. The moon is your crossing. There could be something that is uncertain still, unanswered, mysterious, unknown. There is a Three of Pentacles, having to depend on others, or maybe money is growing, progressing. You're being rewarded for your hard work, but money will be growing for you. But also, this is like a dependency on others where you can rely on them and they can rely on you like a team. What do we have here in the past? Okay. Well, we got a Queen of Coin, a Knight of Coin. There could be any earth sign around you. Someone could be coming towards you, offering you a coin. Got all these cards. I guess I might as well take them. Upcoming energy, Four of Swords. Resting, recovering, relaxing, maybe prayer. Your energy is Ace of Cups. Very strong, powerful feelings. There is someone possibly fighting for something. Seven of Fire. You want to be Page of Wands. You want to be excited, thrilled, opportunistic. The Magician. Okay. Two of Swords. You're dealing with situations where you have to demand answers. You may not even get them with the Four of Swords. Something could be hidden. Somebody could be defending themselves, defending their position. Wow. You got a Ten of Cups as the outcome. Unlimited potential, unlimited fulfilled happiness. Family, friends, community. Emotions are completely and utterly fulfilled. So this makes me feel really good. You have this Ace of Water that you're going to will be influencing your energy. Two of Cups is underlying a partnership, an alliance, a mutual exchange, allies, partners, friends. Somebody around you is in a defensive posturing. They're pushing someone away. They're standing on their ground. Why is there a Four of Swords here coming up? Two of Coin. You'll have a choice to make between two things, two options. What is the Knight of Coin? The Page of Cups. Somebody's very loyal to you. It could be a water sign, but it could also be you are loyal to someone else. On your mind is Knight of Coins. Slow, careful progress. You feel very strongly about something. What is the Seven of Fire here? Temperance. This person needs patience. They need to handle their emotions. They could be overly emotional, reacting. Why are you Ace of Cups here, Aries? You have a lot of experience. King of Coin and the World. There's something that you have a lot of experience in. There's a Page of Water here. That's a pretty a novice. What do we have as the Page of Cups? The Nine of Coin. Independent energy. Somebody who does things on their own way. So you're coming up against a Four of Swords. Information is not given to you, and Two of Coin. You have a choice. What is this Four of Swords, Two of Coin? Two of Rods. You feel like something has to be done right away. And you have a victory here. Somebody is standing on the pedestal in this victory hero energy. Why is someone on the defense with the Patience? The Fool card, a new beginning. It could be somebody who doesn't have a lot of experience. The Fool can be fresh, new, taking that leap of faith, someone who's never done something before, doing something for the first time. Why are you ending up a Ten of Cups, a King of Water? a healer, a water sign, someone who is the king of emotions, following their intuition. Water sign energy king. Ooh, and a queen. So we have a emotional match, a king and a queen of water, the death of the four of cups. Okay, so the ending of somebody acting like they don't care, and the magician, something is being solved, fixed, arranged. Eight of rods, something all of a sudden accelerates. Okay, so why is the Knight of Coins something you're aware of? The Fool. New beginnings, trusting, doing something for the first time. The Queen of Air and Seven of Air. Somebody could be criticizing someone for their, something they did was in, they're defending themselves and their position because they did something in a, that could have been lies or deception. Why are you the Ace of Cups? You're the Emperor. You're disappointed in the situation, or you're disappointed in what someone, how they make you feel. And you're taking back your power as the Emperor. You also are a King of Pentacles. You will invest in something slowly, carefully, methodically. With the world, it means you've been through this before. You've done this before. Why is this person so defensive of their position? Page of Pentacles. And a Magician. Okay, King of Pentacles and a Knight of Pentacles. They come forward slowly, or you're coming forward slowly. This could be about money too, Queen of Wands. You could be paying for something. Because your energy was influenced by a King of Pentacles. What's the root of this with the Three of Coin? Why is this here? The High Priestess. Following your intuition about a situation that is shared. Okay, Nine of Cups. Wishes that come true. Wishes that are fulfilled. What is this? Justice? Enforcement of truth? Enforcement of balance? Correction? Why is this person coming through as the Fool? Okay. Walking away from this. Somebody's like, I'll take a risk, but I'm going to walk away if it's not worth it. I'm going to leave. This isn't worth it to me. Okay. And they're defending themselves too. What's the outcome here with the Ten of Cups? You're waiting for an answer. What is this? What is Aries waiting for here? You're waiting for the truth, Ace of Swords. Okay. You're going to be very happy, though. This person is, like, in this defensive posturing. So if there's a person you're dealing with today, and you're asking them about something where the information, the words, the whatever the information is you're trying to get from them doesn't make sense. Moon and Three of Coin. If you're going to depend on this person, but there's a lot of secrets, this person sees it as, well, you're not going to invest, so I'm just going to leave. That could be anybody. It could be somebody you're hiring. It could be anyone. You then are like, okay, Two of Rods, I'm just going to change course. I'm going to pull back, and I'm going to find something that is more, I've got other choices, I've got other options. And what happens here with the Nine of Cups and Justice? King of Wands, taking action, taking the lead, carrying your own wand. Your energy is Emperor and a King of Coin, new fire. Why is the person around you like Eight of Cups to Five of Coin? Like, if you won't pay me, or if you won't invest, Four of Wands, stability. Why are they walking away, Eight of Cups? The Empress, they have high standards. You're an emperor, though. They're an empress, which means they've already manifested. They've manifested everything that they have. They could have a successful business. It's like somebody doesn't want to answer questions. They don't want to provide documents. They don't want to give the information that you need. And so they're like, well, if you won't give it, then I'm out of here. It's really weird. Oh, wow. You're coming out as a hero. You don't see that, though. You don't see it yet. That you're succeeding over this challenge. The World and the Hermit. Seven of Cups. Seven of Cups and Eight of Swords is like, I don't know what's going on here. The information doesn't make sense. So what is the Ten of Cups, Nine of Cups, Justice? Okay, this person that you're dealing with is in a Seven of Fire. They're standing their ground. They could even feel like they are elevated above others, and so they block. It comes in with a Four of Wands, which is like they've established themselves at a certain place. Wow, this King of Coin, it could be an earth sign, it could be anybody, but the Hermit, finding out information, discoveries, illuminating and highlighting, and then we have here the Victory again, Six of Wands. Five of Swords, what you don't see. This person could be really bitter. There they are. So to clarify what they're going through and why they're defending themselves, it's Five of Coin. They feel like this isn't worth it. You're not going to give them what they need, and you feel like they're not giving you what you need. There is a pentacle here that is needed. And Four of Swords, Knight of Swords, like somebody just shuts off or won't talk. So then again, bottom of the deck, Two of Rods. It pulls you back. Like, say you're in a marketplace. Say you're in, like, some market. And you go up to a stall and you start asking questions about a product. And the person is like, don't ask me questions about it. It's top quality. Don't ask me. I don't even know. I don't have the ingredients. I don't know what's in it. But it is the best. And if you're not going to pay, then I'm out of here. I'm leaving. I already have a client list. And you're like, well, I just wanted to know what was in your product. Like, where was it made? And they come across as like, I don't need you, I'm not on board, you're not going to give me what I want, and in fact, I have everything I want and need. Kind of like a, I don't want to say spoiled, because they have manifested their Empress energy, like they have manifested it. But you're not in the wrong. You're coming in as King of Coin, World, and Emperor. You're like, I've done this before. I've already bought this product before. I've been buying this product for 20 years. I know what this product is. And if you won't simply, because this is all minor arcana. These are all like just simple energies. And then they come in with Empress. Well, like, well, I don't need to answer you. Okay. So it makes you pull back and start to walk around the market and look at other stalls. Like, okay, well, I'm just going to go over here. Two of Swords. Ugh. Two of Swords. You don't really know why they won't answer your questions, why they are so defensive. And so it makes you reconsider. It makes you start to shop around. So then when you start to shop around, because you go from a Three of Wands, like I've already made up my mind, I'm buying this product. You go back to a Two, like, okay. Well, let me reconsider what I'm doing here. Knight of Coin. You want to make slow changes. You're not wanting to make Three of Cups, Six of Cups. You may have had an experience like this before, so you are trying to make very cautious decisions. What's the outcome about Justice, Nine of Cups, Ten of Cups? Knight of Fire and King of Water. Somebody is restless and they just want to get this situation going. They just want to invest their feelings. Okay, you may not like the truth when you find out. So say you're asking somebody what's in the product. You may not, I don't know, Three of Swords is like, that makes me feel like, well, the truth could be something more personal, because I think Three of Swords is like personal. So the person could say, well, I just don't like you, so I'm not doing it. And you go, oh, okay, you're not going to sell to me because you just don't like me? And they say, yeah, I just don't like you. See, Six of Air to the Sun. They leave. You find this out. And that's the best. That's actually better. Ten of Cups, Nine of Cups. Justice is served. The Emperor taking back your power. The High Priestess following your intuition, listening to Divine Feminine. King of the Sword, somebody's very straightforward, and a Queen of the Coin. That could be you, maybe buying something, paying for something. Hierophant, following the rules. The Nine of the Coin. So you're aware of wanting to do something on your own, or you become aware of somebody who wants to do something on their own program. Knight of Coin, Nine of Coin. Knight of Coin moves really slow, very cautious, and that's what you're aware of. But Nine of Coin is like, well, I'm just going to do this all by myself. I'm just not even going to work in a team. The root of the issue is a team. What's the team? If somebody's pushing you out of a team, then you're not even on their team. And if you're asking questions about their team, and they won't tell you, they say, well, I don't need you anyway. It seems like red. Okay, Queen of Swords, like you want the truth. So then two of wands, you go back to the drawing board and you're like, okay, well, let me reconsider. And you start to do some research, and then you have here moderation and the enforcement of correction. Something is corrected. Four of Coin, very cautious. All right, let's see. It's important to be cautious if you have a Six of Cups to a Three of Cups. You've been through something before with people. So you're like, well, I'm really cautious. I don't really like to join things if I don't know what it's all about. I don't really want to like invest my money into something if I don't know like what am I paying for. So this person, though, they may do a personal attack. They may like say, well, we don't want someone like you in our group anyway. And you say, well, I'm the Emperor and the King of Coin and World. Like, I've done this 100 times. Like, I'm an expert. And in fact, like, I'm not investing in you. And they say, well, that's fine. You're not giving me what I need. I'm worth it. And so I don't need you. Which is their truth. They are like, our company, our business doesn't need you. You might be overqualified if you're doing something, you might be overqualified. So the outcome is a Ten of Cups, a Nine of Cups, Truth, Emperor, Justice, the Death of the Four of Cups. Somebody acts like they just don't care. So, Sun card. This is the most positive card in this deck. It has to do with happiness, growth, positive energy. It is an Ace of Pentacles. Oh, we got the soulmates, the two swans, the mother bear of protection, the magnifying glass. You're looking at something very, very closely. Before you'll move forward. The moon, it's hidden on purpose for a reason. S- stay grounded with the anchor. Like, there's a reverse psychology, too, where somebody can attack you when you're just asking them about their background. And they could say, well, what do you need to know that for? You don't know anything. You don't know what you're doing. Fine. And then they leave. And then you start to question yourself, like, oh, well, they're kind of right. But you're like, well, I was just asking, like, simple questions. They're all red flags. All of it. They are in an Empress energy, which means they do have enough. Like, they could have a big client list. But the fact that they won't give you simple things is like, you get justice out of this. The sacrifice and the time. Yeah, this could be a waste of your time. It's a sacrifice of time. There's a challenge with the mountain and a letter. Somebody is sneaky with the fly fox. Someone you're trying to connect to. There is unconditional love and support that you have for someone. And there's a thief. The mask. You might be finding out about something. It's all red flags, because if somebody is not willing to just give you the simple information, it sounds to me like they're wasting your time then. So if they don't need you as a client, they don't need you on their list, they don't need you in their group, at their business, what have you, they're extremely defensive. They shut off, or there's no communication with this person. They don't answer the phone. They don't call you back. You leave messages. It's just like, it's all red flags. They might be a waste of your time. So that's what I have for you, Aries. You end up much happier. Ten of Cups to the Justice to the Nine of Cups and Truth. But you don't like the truth. The truth is personal. The Ace of Swords is a Three of Swords. You won't like what you find out that they are, or something like that. So that's what I have for you, Aries. Keep it all in mind that this is a general read. So I will see you next time, Aries. Take care.